on, Jeffrey. You can do it. Pave the way, put your back into it. Show us why. Tell us how. Look at where you came from. Look at you now. We're redesigning Amazon today. It's the first user-generated content suggestion. So I'm just stoked on that. Endless supply of content ideas incoming from the rest of you, which by virtue of watching this video, have to contractually submit a comment with a new content suggestion. I'm excited to do this. Amazon is a place where I personally, and likely you have, spent a fortune. I've spent so much money on Amazon, but yet, specifically the mobile interface for the shopping application, just has a couple of hangups. There's a lot of weird quirks with the app. It seems very unfocused, and it's not and it's not really clear to me as a user where my attention needs to go when I'm browsing the flow. But before we just jump into the redesign, I want to take a step back and say that this is a design that I'm approaching with humility, right? I would never recommend that anyone at Amazon or any large company where there's like real money on the line goes and just starts designing things for the sake of improving the perceived usability. Because obviously you could make design changes that seem intuitive to you, but the person on the other side of the experience, the one consuming it, the end user, might find it weird and clunky and hard to use. So absolutely have to start with user discovery, and that's like a multi-month project before you create a single wireframe, right? And Amazon, honestly, given the size that they are, they do a pretty damn good job. And I'd imagine that a lot of the stuff that you see on the app is really just A/B testing. But anyway, we're going to take a stab at redesigning the homepage with usability in mind and a series of what I think to be the ideal kind of user stories from my personal experience using the Amazon app. But as you can see here in Figma, we've got our standard brand guidelines as before. This is just the color palette you've likely seen on Amazon before. And they actually use a custom font, the Amazon team, and it is called Amazon Ember. Really fancy. I really like the font. It's very clean, nice rounded edges, but not too rounded where it feels kind of corny. And I've also gone ahead and created a couple of components, just little pictures of potential products and a little rating component to save us a whole bunch of time. Really, when we're done, I'm hoping that we can kind of just scroll through it and understand what we're looking at and what the app wants us to look at and, you know, potentially find more products that are meaningful to someone like me, a potential customer. So here we go. We've got the user stories again. I'm not going to belabor you by reading them all, but the main one is I want to easily navigate to new products that I need or want to buy and quickly determine the best option, whatever that is to me. And then there's a lot of other secondary goals that I think the user would want to accomplish. Like if I'm just browsing and I just want to buy something, a lot of people just browse recreationally. I want to be able to see things presented to me that match my interests. And then of course I want to access the common account details and order history, things like that. And I'd also like to be able to use my voice to shop if I'm really hamming it up and I just don't want to lift a finger to buy myself another box of cheese puffs. So let's get in there and see what we come up with. Often when I start a design project, I'll get really overwhelmed with all the different stories I need to pack into particularly small mobile interfaces. So I'll start with a really low fidelity wireframe like this, where I'm just putting generic content boxes into the flow where I think they would make sense without fleshing out all the details. I'm saving all that brain power for compartmentalizing those individual problems later in the design process. And what you're going to see me do throughout this redesign is essentially making sure that the controls that people are most commonly using are very easy to reach with your thumb if you're just holding your phone in one hand. So generally speaking, people go to Amazon to search for a new product or check on their orders. So the search bar is kind of right there at the bottom of the screen, readily available for users' thumbs. And the menu, kind of a secondary use case, will, as you'll find later, is much higher in the flow.
I stole this idea from the existing app, but I'm adding a context menu for when the user clicks on the search control to give them a list of recent searches, because sometimes when I'm browsing Amazon, I just kind of want to go back into a previous session and look at more products that I looked at previously, and this is kind of a quicker way to do that. Unfortunately, ads are a necessary evil in the realm of design, but honestly, I don't really think people have a problem with advertisements. They have a problem with advertisements done poorly. So here, instead of taking up the entire half of the screen, I'm just making the advertisement a little smaller and a little more accessible. Little bit of sales psychology here. Whenever you're presenting a price to a user that is discounted, if you just show them the percentage, you're kind of asking someone to do some pretty annoying math in their head when you generally don't want people to be thinking way too critically when they're trying to make purchasing decisions. So just doing that math for them saves a bunch of time and usually increases conversions. Similar to the redesign we did at the Steam store, it's generally easier to get someone to commit to buying something if you only show them one option that's highly curated to their interests. So that's what I'm doing here at the top. And then if users want to continue to browse, which they would indicate to the app by scrolling down past that promotion, they're then presented with larger collections of potential offers. I really liked this idea that kind of exists throughout the Amazon app where they float the most commonly used features to the top of the UX and then kind of hide everything else in a deeper menu. So what I'm doing here is if the user opts to look at the menu, I'm floating the most commonly clicked links to the top so they don't have to scroll through hundreds and hundreds of links to find what they want. But if they do want to dig a little deeper into each given category, they can do that with the link on the right. Amazon has a very complicated account hierarchy system where one user can have multiple accounts, personal accounts, business accounts, or one user can have more than one address that they want deliveries sent to. So having some kind of way for the user to switch context for purchases at any given moment made sense for the UI flow here, and that's what you're seeing me build now. This is probably the most opinionated part of the redesign, but I'm floating the most commonly used functions of the application as small quick links above the hover menu here. This allows users that come into the experience to do one thing in particular, like check an order or get a code when they're at Whole Foods, to do that without having to go through all the several clicks. And I'm also expecting these buttons will fade away if a user doesn't interact with them immediately. All right, there we go. So there's a lot that's different about this aesthetic. Particularly, there's just a lot more or a lot less going on visually. Whenever I'm presented with a deal or something, it's very thought out and presented to me in context. And if there's ever, you know, a situation where I want to display to the user many different items, they're pushed off screen. Again, not necessarily the best for accessibility, but we could probably have a setting to sort that out for people that are visually impaired. Of course, users can simply search things they want. Everything's in context for them when they need it to be. They've got a menu that's kind of organized in a way that's designed to make sure the most important information floats to the top. And then we've got some little quick links here to kind of access the most common use cases whenever someone opens the Amazon app. So that's it for now. Let me know what you think in the comments. Jeff Bezos, please don't sue me. I guarantee that this was a completely creative endeavor, and no way was I intending to infringe on any copyright. I think this is a lot cleaner. I think I would be much happier using an interface like this, but like I said at the start, it's a very complicated UX. You gotta respect the broad spectrum of different user personas that a company like Amazon has when redesigning something like this. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed it. And until next time, all hail our Amazonian overlords.